Okay, we're going to find the slope of the line that has these two points. The first one is -3, 1, and then the second point is -3, 5. We are given two points, therefore we have to use the slope formula, and this is something that we have to remember. M stands for the slope, and the formula tells us that we are going to have y2 minus y1, and this is over x2 minus x1. Okay? And when we have these two points, let's just label the first point as x1, y1. And for the second point, right here, we label this as x2 and y2. And now we can just plug in this value into this formula accordingly. So you will see this is going to give us, let me write it down here, y2 is 5. So I'll just put down 5 right here. And we are going to minus the y1 value, which is 1. And then this is going to be over x2, which is -3, right? So let's put down -3. And then we are going to subtract x1 value is -3. So let me put down -3, and let me put parentheses around it. And now we just have to work this out. Let's do the top first. 5 minus 1, that's 4. And this is over. On the denominator, this is what? This is technically saying -3, and then minus negative becomes plus 3. So what's -3 plus 3? The answer to that part is 0. At the end, this is what we have, 4 over 0. But what's the response for this? The answer to that. Remember, we cannot have a 0 in the denominator. This right here is undefined. Okay? If the 0 was on the top, then the answer would be 0. But 0 is in the denominator in our case. So this right here is undefined. And how can we end up with a slope that's undefined? What does that mean? Here, right here, we have actually a vertical line. Because when you have this point, -3, 1, let me just write it down right here. This is -3, this is 1. This is the first point, which is this point. And we also have -3, 5. Let's say this is 5 here. -3, 5. And you see, when we connect the dots, we end up with a vertical line. Vertical line has undefined slope. This is it.